Is this how you do it right now? Inserting shapes? Or perhaps a little more advanced method using smart art? Stop struggling. Let me show you an easier way to create an organization chart using Excel templates. No more add-ins, no more subscription fee. It is easy, fast, and beautiful. You can get this template from our website. Just check out the link in the description. Now let's take a look what's inside. Go to Setup tab, and first thing you're gonna see is Auto Setting. Just leave it on for now, I'll explain about it a bit later. The second thing is Picture Setting. This setting will indicate the location of your pictures. There are two boxes that we can fill. The first one is the location of all the pictures, and the second one is the exact location and names of the default picture. Create a new folder anywhere on your computer. I'm going to name it Orchard Picture. Then double click your folder open. Now right click and choose Copy Address as Text. Come back to our organization chart generator files. Double click and paste it in here. Next is default picture, and this will come in handy when we don't have the picture of that person just yet. This is the example of the default picture, but you can choose any picture you like, and let's rename it to default. Since we are putting our default picture in the same folder as other picture, what we can do is we can copy the address here and paste it into default picture. After that, just put a backslash and a default picture name in here, which in this case, we put default.jpg. And that's the only two things you need to do in picture settings. Next is our organization chart information. There's already an example in here, and this example is creating this chart right here. But in this video, we're going to do it together. So let's erase all of this and we'll start from the top. The only two things that's required in this template is the employee name and supervisor name. Position and remark is optional. Column G to column J are things that in the auto setting, we can leave it blank and we will do some more additional setting after we fill out the employee and supervisor name. The last is error remark. If you see red text in column K, make sure you fix them first before you creating the chart. Now let's do some typing. The first line is usually for the leaders. And the important thing about this line is that we cannot have anything in the supervisor column, not the dash, not space. If you see an error remark, incorrect supervisor name on the leaders row, first thing you can do is come to column D and check to make sure it's completely empty, not even a space in there. And in this case, I think there's space in there, so I'm gonna erase everything and hit enter again. And here we go, the error remark is disappeared, so we're good to go. Let's keep on typing. Besides typing it directly into the templates, if you already have a list of names in other Excel files, you can also copy and paste to save time. And the paste method that I recommend is paste as value. If you see an error here saying incorrect supervisor name, chances are there are some mistyping in the name. So let's find out. So I mistype William and I'm gonna change that. Now the incorrect supervisor name disappeared. Still error here in Elizabeth Davies. I also mistype here, so I'm gonna change from S to D and hit enter. So now all the error is gone. That's the only two column that is required, but I am going to put the position in there as well. So let's copy and paste add value. I am going to leave the remark blank for this example. Now let's look at the section, position, auto site vertical, and picture files name. There is nothing to be further set in auto section. Just make sure that you leave this one on. Next is the position. You can put the number in this box, and this number will indicate whether the underling of that supervisor will organize horizontally or vertically. Let me quickly show you an example. Currently, I set it at number 2, and this is how our organization chart looks like. If any supervisor has more than two underlings, their underlings will organize vertically. But since all the supervisors in this example only have two underlings maximum, that's why they are all organized horizontally like this. If I change this auto setting into 1, and this is how it look like. So instead of having them horizontally like we did before, now everything is going down vertically. Depend on whichever layout you like, you can adjust the setting accordingly. But for now, we're gonna keep it at 2. Next is the side vertical, and this is how it works. You can put any words into this box separated by comma. And if this word appear in any of the position, it will automatically go to side vertical. And side vertical looks something like this. So in this case, I put if the position contain the word secretary or PA to someone, then make that person side vertical. If you're looking in the list, we'll see that Sarah Johnson, her position is PA to the CEO. So that will automatically make Sarah Johnson side vertical. Last one is picture file's name. So instead of typing one by one, Lisa.jpg, Sarah.jpg, you can keep this auto function on and the template will generate the picture file's name for you. You can only use one extension for all the picture. And that was it for the information. Now let's prepare our pictures. Go to the folder that we've created earlier. Now put the picture of our employee in here. And if you put the picture file's name to auto, make sure you set the name like this. First name, space, the initial of the last name, dot whatever file's extension you've put in the auto section. After you have everybody's picture in here and name it correctly, you're all set for the picture. The template will automatically grab the picture from this folder and put it by their names. Next, we'll go to the design setting. This step is very simple. You can choose any design you like by clicking on this number right here. There are 10 pre-designed for you to choose from. And for your custom design, we'll touch on it on an advanced video. This style we currently see is style 6. So let's do something like style 8. So click on number 8. And it will change the style for you here. If you don't like any color, you can adjust them. For example, if you don't want this first one to be red, just click on them. First time you will select the whole group, then click on it second time will individually select this shape, then right click, format shape. You will see this menu where you can adjust the color to anything you like. You can also make it solid fill instead of pattern fills, or you can fill it with picture. Same with font. You can click on the font and then change it directly from here. This connector color, you can also change it. Just click on it, click on line, solid line. You can change the color here as well. But if you like what you see, you don't have to do anything, just hit on create chart. Within seconds, you will have your beautiful organization chart done with picture just like this. Time to create an organization chart depends on a few things. First is, how big is your chart? Second is, how detailed is your design? And third is, your computer performance. After your chart is ready, you have a few options. You can print it in PDF, you can set the margin right here, select between landscape and portrait. In this example, let's do landscape PDF. You will have your organization chart ready in one page PDF. You can send it by email, put it in your local drive or share drive. Second option is you can copy the chart and paste it directly. Just hit on copy chart. So you see this message here mean everything's already copied, just hit OK. Open up a PowerPoint, for example. Here you have a few paste options. You can paste it as picture, or you can paste it as shape and you can adjust them later. If you paste them like this, you can click on them and further edit anything you want. Once you already understand how this works and have your data ready, it only takes seconds to create your next beautiful organization chart. See you in the next video for the advanced settings.